الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونشكره ونسأله العفو والعافية والخير في الدنيا وفي الآخرة، ونسأله سبحانه وتعالى أن يصلي على خاتم أنبيائه وإمام المرسلين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن محمداً عبده ورسوله. We praise Allah and we ask Him to grant us what is good for us in this life and in the hereafter. And we ask Him to shower His peace and the blessings on the seal of the prophets, the leader of the messengers, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We bear witness that there is no deity save Allah, and we bear witness that Muhammad is the servant and the messenger of Allah. Dear Muslims, we are living at a very interesting time. Suffice to say that only in the last 2 weeks, the three major national TV stations are dedicating full-time, full programs to speak about Islam and the Muslims in a very unprecedented way. Of course, some of the product is bad, some is good, some is in between. But nonetheless, the phenomena is very clear that there is certain preoccupation and certain attention in an unprecedented way to the issue of Islam and the Muslims. This is coming from the neutral, coming from the friend, and coming from the foe, coming from all the range of the rainbow. The cover of the Time magazine, the articles in the Economics, New York Times, all are dedicating spaces that we could never see occupied by talks about Islam before. It is obvious that this confronts us with a set of challenges and also set of opportunities. And always people are tested, as the Quran said, that Allah tests us bil khayri wa sharri. He tests you by the good and the bad. And the idea of the test is to see how you deal with both. You can deal with the bad to make it worse. You can deal with the good to squander it and let the opportunities go. But on the other hand, you can really deal in a mature, productive, positive way with both, and this is what is expected from Muslims who understand and who represent Islam. And this is something that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the intelligence and the stamina and the purity to be able to make the right choices and to take the correct attitudes. The risks are known. The risks are coming from quarters that we talked several times before, talked about them, and they are coming from religious zealots, from fanatics, from bigots, from people who have political agendas, particularly in an election year, and from quarters that believe that America should be the country monopolized by certain groups, namely the rich white male groups, and all others are accommodated, tolerated, but they should not claim ownership of the American project as they do. So we have these challenges, and we are used to them, and we deal with them day in and day out. Things become complicated when all of this is swimming in an ocean of ignorance. I am still being surprised after all these years in America and after all this age that I see some fellow citizens innocently. Their level of knowledge about Islam is horrifying. Non-existent, and I don't blame them. As a matter of fact, I am more leaning towards blaming us, not them, because it is our job to let people know the truth, not to coerce them to the truth, not to insist to show them the light, but to make them see the truth when they see us and when they listen to us. So it is a challenge to us that we need to deal with. The opportunities is really what is more important now. What kind of opportunities this is offering to us and how we can deal with them. The opportunity that's very obvious and is very clear that there is the human nature makes people curious about things that they don't know. This is why we go to the moon. What is the value of going to the moon? The country was ready to dedicate money and whole science just because it is unknown. And now it seems that we are the moon of the modern age. People want to know what that Islam is, for good or for worst, but there is a level of curiosity that will push people to inquire and to question and to research. And if we are ready with the right attitude and the correct information, the market is demanding you. And we can have a great opportunity. And it's actually happening even without us. The sites on the computer that are about Islam are getting more hits than ever before. The books about Islam are sold more than ever before. The copies of the Quran is distributed more than ever before. So the market dictates its logic. People are curious about something, so they will go and try to know what this thing is. And it always comes to my mind the verse, وَلَا يَعْلَمُ جُنُودَ رَبِّكَ إِلَّا هُوَ. Only Allah knows the agents that will work for Him. And I hope that we are not arrogant enough to think that we are the only ones who are working for Islam. There are people working for Islam without knowing that they are working for Islam. At the end of the day, that funny reverend who wanted to burn the Quran worked for Islam without him being even aware, and didn't occur to him in his worst nightmares. But the service he offered to us, we couldn't offer it to ourselves. So the human nature is confronting us with an opportunity that we can use and we can deal with. The second opportunity that I personally consider very important is that Muslims now are forced to answer questions that they never answered before, they even never dared to ask. Because we have been talking to ourselves. And when we talk to ourselves, we don't challenge ourselves. We don't challenge ourselves to specifics. How come this is written in this book? What it means exactly? Answer me about gender relations. Answer me about the treatment of women. In the past, we just go and we talk to each other and get a nice feeling of being together and Allahu Akbar at the end of the day, and we leave. But now you live in a medium, in an environment that's coming to you now with questions that didn't occur to you, not to answer, but even to ask. And by the way, part of that sector that will come to you with these questions, your own sons and daughters and grandsons and granddaughters who are getting these questions at the schools or at the clubs, and you go to ask who? To ask mom and dad. When mom and dad are surprised by the question, they will not have the answer. So that challenge I am welcoming. because we cannot talking about things that we take for granted, and we please each other by talking to each other about how good we are or how good Islam is, without really going deeper and try to know a convincing way to deal with the surroundings. And I consider this as a very positive development in terms of opportunities. We discovered clearly that the protection that we need will come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through people who are not Muslims. And this is not new. Not new for us, not new for others. But at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as you know from the seerah, that at a certain time they exiled his whole family, his whole branch of the tribe, Bani Hashim, and isolated them, starved them, surrounded them, besieged them, boycotted them, sanctioned them, you name it, to the point of hunger, until they say, when you walk close by the area, you are deafened by the cries of the children who are hungry. It was tough time, because they, Quraysh, and their allies wrote an agreement, a memorandum of understanding, if you will, a treaty, that they will not deal with Bani Hashim, they will not sell to them, they will not buy from them, they will not marry from them. They, period, let them rot there and die. And who broke this treaty? This is not Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the Sahaba, or the ones who broke these treaties are Kafirs of Quraysh, who have something good in them, the gallant character of Arabia, and said, shame on us. How come we allow this to happen? And those A'immatul Kufr, actually, the big guys, went and erased this sahifa, the page, and they brought it and they burned it and said, we can't take it. That took 3 years. Yes, it took 3 years while those people are starving. Nonetheless, it ended by the good nature, the remnants of good nature of some people who are actually enemies. And this should teach us a lesson, because it is repeated at the time of the seerah also, after Hijrat al-Ta'if, for the Prophet to be allowed to enter Mecca in security, he was protected by a kafir from Quraysh, but he is a man of stature, and said, if someone shook hands with me and said, offer me protection, I will. And so the Prophet returned back after the suffering he got in the Taif in protection of that man. So I think Muslims in America now are waking up to this reality. Yes, some of us were talking about that years ago, but it was not sinking. We were still talking about, this is us, our community, our religion, the others are corrupt, we don't want to corrupt ourselves, we don't want to be diluted, they will convert us, etc. So they built this cocoon, and now they all of a sudden discover this cocoon will be crushed soon, if not other citizens will, for other reasons, other than being Muslims, will come and stand up and say, forget about Islam and the Muslims, it's not an issue of Quran or no Quran, it is an issue of American Constitution. And so this is why that reverend was opposed by the main bulk of churches. Not because they love us, some of them might, not because they are truth seekers, some of them maybe, but the majority is, we don't want America to be like that. Because you hit me now, you hit them now, you might hit me tomorrow. And it will be an American life that will not allow people to live freely. And so they stood up very firmly and took a stand that made the guy look exactly like the fool he is. So this is the third opportunity that we are having, and those three opportunities are very important for us to contemplate and to ponder. So we know that we have to turn the table around. Let us face it, the table needs to be turned around. Why? Because even people who like you, number one, they are not the majority, but they say you have the freedom of your religion and absolutely, and this America, but not in my backyard. This is the general attitude. Let us face it. It is a good project, yes, like they say, yes, we need to build a jail because jails are crowded, but not in my district. And we, the situation is like that. So the table has to be turned around. It will not be turned around on its own. We have to work systematically for it. And we have to go through certain steps. Number one, self-correction and self-criticism, and mending and strengthening our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. If you are conscious of God, He will let you out. He will find a way for you out. Then our relationship with each other. As in Surah Al-Anfal, فَاتَّقُوا اللَّهُ وَأَصْلِحُوا ذَاتَ بَيْنِكُمْ. Correct your ranks. At every level, individual, family, institutions, mosques, organizations, whatever. But this is something. Number three, which is very important, have the confidence when you are in that open, tumultuous ocean that we are dealing with. Full of good things, but full of sharks. We have to be confident. And how we are confident? Because we have a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is wa'ad Allah. This is a big term. Wa'ad Allah alladhina amanu minkum wa amilu salihat. Allah gives a promise for those amongst you who believe and do the good things. La yastakhlifannahum fil ardi kama istakhlafa alladhina min qablihim. He will establish them on earth like he did before time. وَلَيُمَكِّنَنَّ لَهُمْ دِينَهُمُ الَّذِي ارْتَضَى لَهُمْ. And the religion will be established for them. وَلَيُبَدِّلَنَّهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ خَوْفِهِمْ أَمْنًا. And he will change the status from fear to confidence and security. This is three promises from Allah. No one of us is allowed hearing that to lose heart. What the Quran is telling us is difficulty is a phase. It will go. Don't lose yourself and your hope and your dignity and your integrity in the bottleneck, because it is just a small piece of the bottle. Soon you will be out, because this promise has to be true. It is a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With this confidence, we then address what is happening and what is going around us. Istaghfiru rabbakum innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Then we have to design programs and to identify steps that we go guided by to be able to deal in a productive way. And those steps are supplied to us, alhamdulillah, by the Quran. There is no rocket science here. There is no genius or discovery. There, if we look carefully, we'll find that all the categories we are talking about are mentioned, and you are guided to deal with them, because you will not deal with all people. There is no all size solution. There is no common recipe. You will develop different attitudes and different arguments and different projects according to the category of people that you will meet. There is a category of people who are completely shut and locked, and they are not ready to even give a chance to change. All of us met people like that. Muslims and non-Muslims, by the way. It's human, human. So you have this category that is closed. على قلوب أقفالها. The heart is locked, finished. And here the Quran told the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم أفأنت تهدي العمية ولو كانوا لا يبصرون. Are you going to make the blind see? The blind of the heart, of course. Even if he or she are already blinded, don't waste your time. There are other categories that need your energy and need your addressing. Then you have people who are just aggressive and insulting. We see that somebody is coming just to bother you or to insult you. A couple of days ago, we were in a public forum in the Central Library of LA, and there was a guy, as a matter of fact, the credit is to my wife that she noticed, the guy is sitting in the front row, sleeping all the time. Sleeping. Almost snoring. Then opened his eye and asked the nasty question. Then slept again. He is coming for that. He is not coming to challenge or to learn or to argue. He is just coming for that. And a smart guy doesn't want to waste his time, so he took a nap, which is okay. For those people, you have to, if they are just coming to insult, we have the guidance of the Quran. وَإِذَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْبَغْيُ هُمْ يَنْتَصِرُونَ. I'm not ready to be insulted. I have the dignity of the Muslim. I respond not in a damaging way, not in an arrogant way, but definitely in an assertive way. Because the Quran said, إِذَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْبَغْيُ هُمْ يَنْتَصِرُونَ, describing the believers. There are people who are having the ignorance of the heart, of the personality, of the attitude. Because there are two kinds of ignorance. Al-jahiliya, which we know, this is not lack of knowledge. This is a character of ignorance. The lack of desire to acquire knowledge. This is the big kind of ignorance. Lack of knowledge is easy. Someone lacking knowledge, give him or her knowledge, a done deal. But if the character is ignorant, that's a problem. Here the Quran says, وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. Say peace or peaceful statement and leave. Because you, the Muslim, your energy and your time are more valuable than that and are needed in other places. And the Quran directed one prophet, يَا قَوْمِ لَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ أُخَاصِمَكُمْ إِلَى مَا أَنْهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ إِنْ أُرِيدُ إِلَّا الْإِصْلَاحَ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُ. I don't want to argue with you. I don't want bad feeling. Then there are people who are really seeking to know. And this is the main field, and this is the majority, by the way, of our society. Here where I offer al-hikmah, وَالْمَوْعِظَ الْحَسَنَ, the wisdom and the nice preaching, so that they understand. There are people who are seeking to know, but they say, I will not change, I will not come to your camp. Fine, but let us agree on a common ground. As the Quran exactly said, قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا إِلَى كَلِمَةٍ سَوَى. Let us agree on an area that we worship Allah and we don't abuse each other by trying to play gods on each other. That's it. This is all what I want from you. Be whatever you are, but don't come and play God on me, because there is only one God, La ilaha illallah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the roadmap that we should follow, and there are projects to serve that, and I want to tell you that there are three good things that are happening. So many good things are happening, alhamdulillah. But the center is having the convention on the 17th about dealing with the other. In general, that's the theme, or dealing with non-Muslims. And I think I ask you to attend to that convention, get the information. There is tonight, there is a TV show on 2020, where we could have two good Muslim sisters who are very well spoken, well versed, will be part of that program. So at least it's not like another program that's being arranged also by Christiana Amanapour, which is for 90% of the panel is staunch enemies of Islam. And they put 10% just for beautification. But it's okay, we take whatever, and maybe the 10% will become more respected than the 90%. Then there is a call that I got from one of the major chairs, and believe it or not, they want a six weeks course on Quran. Remember, لا يعلم جند ربك إلا هو. They feel that the clientele of the church want to know Quran. So they are coming to get so that we help them with this 6 weeks course in Quran. So I think we explored the channels, the challenges, and there is nothing new. What's new is the way we become aware of the opportunities and how we develop a Quranic driven agenda to deal with them. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the right path and to enlighten our way through the darkness and to give us the courage of the heart and the intelligence of the mind and the umf and the stamina that we need, al-azm, to carry on this great mission. And I ask Allah to support this center and the institutions that emerged out of it to fulfill that goal. And I ask him to forgive our shortcomings and forgetfulness and mistakes and to reward us according to our intentions, inshallah. Allahumma ighfir lana warhamna wa'afina wa'afu anna wa tawallana wa tub alayna wa dafi' anna wa dfi' anna kulla sharrin wa kulla su' wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen wa salli allahumma ala muhammadin aqim as-salam.